Forgetful Guttu. A long time ago, a boy named Guttu lived with his parents in a city. Though he was a good boy in every sense, but he had a problem of forgetting things. Often he forgot small things.
I'm smart and I know it. I'm smart and I know it. Oh, I came to my school. I was supposed to go to the market. I'm so forgetful.
Guttu's mother tried a lot of things to cure this forgetting habit of Guttu. By eating this almond dessert, my Guttu will surely get rid of his problem. But it did not make any difference in this habit of Guttu.
Guttu, I asked you to bring curd and you bought milk instead. When will you get rid of this forgetting problem of yours?
In Guttu's class, his fellow students also used to make fun of his problem.
Guttu, today you should take me along on your way back. There is a possibility that you may forget your destination.
And Guttu always got angry on them.
I don't need your service at all. As usual, today also my mother will come and pick me up.
One day, Guttu, while alone in the classroom, was learning a lesson. His friend, Rohit, came over there and told his two friends.
Have you seen how comfortably Guttu is learning his lesson over there? Come, let's tease him.
Yes, come, let's tease him.
But what will we do?
I have a wonderful plan.
Saying this, Rohit told his plan to both of them, and then two of his friends remained there and Rohit came near Guttu.
What are you doing, Guttu?
I'm preparing for my test.
But our exam is tomorrow. Come, let's play.
No, I don't want to play with you. You always make fun of me.
Yes, but at this moment I wish to play with you.
I told you that I don't want to play with you.
Rohit's friend saw all this from behind, and Rohit had confused Guttu in his thoughts. And according to the plan, very quietly, they came over there and they took out Guttu's English notebook from his school bag and went from there.
All right, don't play if you don't wish to.
Saying this, Rohit also went from there. He took Guttu's book from his friends and hid it somewhere. After some time, bell rang for the next period and their English teacher came to the classroom.
Kids, I will check English notebooks of each and every one of you. Therefore, one by one, all of you come with your notebooks to me.
The teacher started checking notebooks of every child. On opening his bag, Guttu found that his notebook wasn't there and he got frightened by this.
Where is my notebook? I kept here in the bag in the morning. Or I must have forgotten. Whatever it is, now teacher will be very angry.
And then teacher called Guttu.
Guttu, now you come up with your notebook.
Guttu got very scared and he stood up.
Teacher, today I forgot to bring my notebook.
You forgot to bring your notebook?
Sorry, teacher.
Guttu, if you don't come up with your notebook tomorrow, then I will straight away take you to the principal. Understood?
Okay, teacher.
On seeing Guttu getting scolded, Rohit and his friends became very happy. After school, Rohit and his friends went near Guttu. Rohit returned Guttu's notebook back.
Take this, your notebook.
Was this with you?
Yes, while I was talking to you, then very quietly, my friends took this out from your bag.
But why did you do this? I'll tell everything to the teacher.
But teacher won't believe it. After all, everyone knows that how forgetful you are.
This Rohit always makes fun of me. I'll surely teach him a lesson someday.
Next day, Rohit was playing with his friends. And then, Guttu quietly went near his bag and took his Hindi notebook out from his bag and went from there.
Our English teacher is very cool. But Hindi teacher, she's so hot-headed. Now Rohit will come to know.
Saying this, Gattu hid Rohit's notebook somewhere. After some time, when the bell rang for the next period, their Hindi teacher came to the class. Teacher said to the students,
"Today I will check everyone's homework. Therefore, all of you, one by one, come with your notebook to me. Rohit, first you come."
On opening his bag, Rohit was unable to find his Hindi notebook. Scared, he stood up and said,
"Madam, it seems I forgot to bring my Hindi notebook today."
"What? You didn't brought your Hindi notebook today? There is no use of saying sorry now. You should get punishment. Stand up on your seat and raise both your hands."
Rohit raised both of his hands and stood on his seat. Seeing this all, the kids started laughing.
"You called me forgetful."
Now Gattu took his revenge. As soon as bell rang for the next period, Hindi teacher went from there and Gattu went to Rohit.
"You hid my notebook, Rohit. Now how does it feel?"
"Means you have hidden my notebook?"
"Yes, because you hid my notebook."
"All right, if now your revenge is over, then please return my notebook to me."
"Wait, I shall bring it right away."
Saying this, Gattu came out from there. But due to his forgetful nature, he wasn't able to recall that where he kept Rohit's notebook.
"I'm unable to recall that where did I hide his notebook. What shall I do now?"
After returning, he told everything to Rohit. And after listening to him, Rohit got very angry.
"What? You have lost my notebook? Now what will I show to our Hindi teacher tomorrow? I will complain against you to the principal."
Saying this, Rohit went to the principal and told the entire matter to him.
"Principal sir, I just merely joked with Gattu, but he lost my notebook."
"Gattu and Rohit, you both are at fault. So you both now shall be punished. Now both of you will purchase a new notebook. And in that, half lessons you both will copy. And by the next week, we'll hand it over to your Hindi teacher. Understood?"
Yes, Principal Sir.
This way, due to Rohit's mischievousness and Gattu's anger and forgetfulness, Principal punished both of them.